Hey guys, the Pro Rancher here. So this is the same snake that I skinned in my last video. So today I'm going to go ahead and show you how to flesh it and get it ready to tan. So basically, to start out, you need a nice small knife. This thing's pretty sharp. Sharper is better always. So when I say flesh, I mean on the inside here, particularly on the belly scales, there is a fleshy substance. I don't know if you can see that, but it's kind of gelatinous. I mean, you can almost say it's the fat. But you really have to remove that, because if you don't remove that, it will rot, and when you try to tan it, it will just go bad and make a big nasty mess. So you need to clean that off as much as possible, and the best way to do that is to just simply scrape it. Now, these things can be kind of difficult to work with. They want to kind of curl up on you. But essentially, you're just going to take your knife and scrape it like so, and all that stuff kind of comes off in like a goo, like that. So basically, you're just going to do that for the entire snake. And normally, I would do it the other direction. You want to go with the grain of the scales, usually is a lot better. And just try not to put too much pressure. You don't want to break the scales. You don't want to tear the skin or cut the skin. Yeah, I'm really struggling here. Sorry about that. It's kind of a small snake to begin with. But as you're doing this, you'll notice that the skin looks a lot cleaner. And it becomes a lot thinner as well. And I'm just kind of starting out. It's usually harder once you start. Once you get going, you know, you get your rhythm going, everything works out a lot better. It starts to go smooth and fast. And I always find the end parts, you know, the ends of the snake are always the hardest to get going. So once you get past these parts, and it's really sticky too. In case you're wondering where I learned this, I know a guy that's a taxidermist, and he taught me how to properly go through this process and tan the skin the way he does it. I'm sure there are other ways, so I'm not going to sit here and tell you that this is the only way to do this. This just happens to be a way that works, and if you want to try it, go for it. If you know another way, do that too. Do that or whatever you want to do. So this is going to take a long time, so I'm not going to record the entire thing, but you get the idea. You just go along, do a little section at a time. Most of the flesh on this snake, it's a small snake, most of it's going to be on the belly scales. I mean, there's a little bit inside here, so I'm just doing that as I go along, but most of it's going to be in the belly. And you really, really, really want to get it all off, or like I said, it will go bad and ruin the entire thing. So I think you guys get the point. I'm going to go ahead and cut the camera off now and finish the job up, and then I'll show you how to make up the snake tan and how to get it set up for that. Okay, so now the fleshing job is completely done. As you can see, I got a little bit of a mess here. Got quite a bit of flesh off of this skin, and that's pretty much normal. You're going to get a lot off of there. That's why you have to get it off, because if that was left on there, imagine that rotting. Okay, so this is my homemade snake tan. This recipe was given to me by a taxidermist, so I trust it and I've used it and it works. As you can see written there, it is 50% alcohol and 50% glycerin. Both of those items can be picked up at your local pharmacy. Just go up and ask them. If you can't find the glycerin, sometimes they have that behind the counter and you just have to ask for it. Yeah, it's not a big deal. It just comes in a little jar. It's kind of a clear, thick, clear liquid.
And you just add it to the alcohol, and it just creates sort of a oily substance. Anyway, that's your snake tan. You can go online and find pre-made snake tans for sale. That's totally okay to do if you find it. But this is how you make it. This is how I make it anyway. I just buy the two and I mix them together. Okay, so first thing we're gonna do to get our snake skin ready is we want to, you want to start at the head end, and you're going to start to roll it inwards, scale side out, and I'm not rolling it very tight. The point is you want it to be loose so that when you put it in the solution, it can get in there and absorb into all the layers. You know, if you put it too tight, it won't do that. Actually, it helps to have the snake kind of laid out ahead of time. At this point, it's very sticky. As you can see, it's sticking to itself. All right, there we go. So now we got it rolled or laid out. We can roll it up. Very loose. And again, this can be any kind of snake. It does not have to be a rattlesnake. And also, as a side note, I wanted to say to all you guys that may have been mad at me for killing the snake in the first place, all you snake lovers. Well, I am a snake lover myself. I respect snakes. I like snakes. I've had them as pets my entire life. I've been handling them my entire life. That's why I'm so comfortable with them. I really like snakes, and that's why I'm actually doing this. I mean, I don't want to just kill it and throw it off to the side. If I'm going to go through this process, you know, if I'm going to kill a snake, I want to respect it. Okay, so anyway, there's a snake rolled up, not too tight. And I've already got a jar picked out that I figured was going to be about the right size. I've used it before, so I know that a standard size snake will fit in there, an average, standard, average snake. Just going to put that in there like that. And fill up our jar all the way. It's important that the snake be all the way underneath. So you want to have it filled up to the very top. As much as you can. And we're going to seal it off. And that's it. Give it a shaking to make sure it loosens up and gets the fluid inside of there everywhere. Okay, so now this is going to take a couple weeks. You're going to leave it in here, and you're basically going to come out in like almost once a day. I would just give it a good shaking, just to, like I said, get the stuff in between all the different layers and also keep the mixture mixed up properly so that the two materials don't separate. Okay guys, well that's how you tan a snake skin. I hope you enjoyed the video. Make sure you give it a like, share, and favorite, and we'll see you guys next time.
Are you gonna eat that?